Hello again, welcome. This is the Minority Health Report with Dr. O. This channel is dedicated to issues surrounding healthcare in the minority population of the United States. We discuss and highlight some of the troubles we face and hopefully propose some solutions to deal with these problems. Today, I'm going to title this talk, The Trouble with Black Men, and we're going to be looking at health statistics amongst black men. I'll tell you, buckle up, this is not a very happy episode because it reveals a bunch of things we already knew, but maybe gloss over. We're going to delve into these and we hopefully are going to touch on some of the salient points that would help improve some of these outcomes. I'm going to focus my data today primarily from two sources. There's a lot that's been written about health outcomes in minorities, especially in black men, but I pulled up data from the CDC as well as a recent analysis from Very Well Health. Very Well is an editorial group that synthesizes health information in a way where it is easily consumable and where the information you are receiving is reliable as well. I'm going to start with the CDC. The death rate of African Americans from 1999 to 2015 decreased by 25%. So that's the good news. That's about the only good news, honestly. Overall, death rate decreased by 25% if you go back to 1999 up until 2015. However, get this, in African Americans, this is overall, in African Americans age 18 to 49, we are two times as likely to die from heart disease than from the white population. Also, between ages 35 and 64, you are 50% more likely to have high blood pressure than in the white population. Think about it. You're two times more likely to die from heart disease between ages 18 and 49 before you make 50 years old. And between 35 and 64, you are 50% more likely to have high blood pressure. That's just the beginning of bad news. The report from Very Well Health highlights some things that I know already, I see with my patients that I talk about all the time, but to put it all in black and white on a page begins to focus the mind. Their opening remarks says, and I'm going to read verbatim because I think it's important. Black men in the United States suffer worse health outcome than any other racial group in America. For example, black men have the lowest life expectancy and the highest death rate from specific causes compared with both men and women of other ethnic or racial groups. Black men suffer the lowest life expectancy and the highest death rate, regardless what the data point you're looking at. What are the leading causes of death amongst the African-American population, but among black men? 10 top contenders. Number one is heart disease. Number two is cancer, unintentional injuries, homicide, stroke, diabetes, chronic lung problems, kidney problems, infections, high blood pressure. These are actually things that are very common in our community that we see, I see every day with my patients. I tell my patients all the time that blood pressure, diabetes, heart disease, this is almost, unfortunately, bread and butter in the African American community. And yet, guess what? Our attitude towards coming to the doctor to get help when we need is something that we need to address. Going to the doctor on a regular basis, keeping your appointments, taking your medications, these are important things. One of the main things I want to pick out on: cancer is the number two cause of death amongst black men. Number two cause of death. Cancer, that includes lung cancer, that includes colon cancer, that includes prostate cancer. But I cannot tell you how many times a patient comes to me for their physical and they would not want to get a prostate exam done and they would not go for their colonoscopy test done. Why? Because of cultural attitudes. And I'll give two important examples. A few years ago, a 60-something-year-old male came in for the first time As usual, his wife was the one that said, go get your physical, you haven't seen a doctor in many years. On his first visit, he also gave an attitude about getting a prostate exam, also gave an attitude about getting a colonoscopy. But his first visit to a doctor in many years, I insisted he must get a prostate exam, I insisted he must get a colonoscopy, and guess what? From his first visit, I diagnosed him with prostate cancer, I diagnosed him with colon cancer from his first visit. Within a 6-month period, he lost so much weight because he underwent 2 major surgeries and through 2 chemotherapy sessions for prostate cancer and for colon cancer. Today, he swears by me. He says, whatever I say, doctor, he will do. But on his first visit to me, it was like pulling teeth to get him to do what he should do. I use him as an example, and he knows I tell the story about him all the time because it is an instance of our attitudes and how it adversely affects us. Another one more recently, maybe just a few months ago, a gentleman in his 40s with his wife came in for their annual exams. The same thing, he wouldn't want to get examined. On the same visit, on their physical, I diagnosed him with prostate cancer, I diagnosed his wife with colon cancer from routine office checks, office visits. These are things, these are real life examples that happen here all the time, that I deal with all the time, that happen within my community, that is important for us to pay attention to. Some of the reasons that have been given why our health statistics is so bad, some of it again is listed out here. Racial discrimination, high rates of incarceration, unemployment, no insurance, cultural barriers, poverty, and all of that. But I think one of the more telling bits amongst all of this is really our cultural attitude to getting the care that we need. Because even though all of this is real, at the end of the day, even when you have access, you have insurance, your attitude to going to your doctor is still not what it should be. So I'm calling out all black men out there, please stay alive. We have a generation of young ones coming up behind us. We need to set examples, and we need to be here for our community. We need to lead our community. And by the way, I'm calling on all the women in their lives, please continue to do what you do. Make your men go get their annual physicals. Make your men keep their doctor appointments. Make the men in your lives take care of their health. Because the statistics are so bad. The statistics are so bad. We cannot continue to blame other people when we haven't done the bit that we should do ourselves. One of the things I deal with here, patients come to me and they argue with me, Dr. O, my blood pressure is usually high. And then my response is, what do you mean your blood pressure is usually high? We all obey the same laws of nature. You don't tell me gravity affects you less than it affects me. You don't tell me that the IRS will not come after you and will come after me or any of those things. All of those, or that the speed limit on the highway is different for you than it is for me. We all obey the same laws. We all go by the same rules. Your blood pressure has been your blood pressure control is defined as X. You cannot redefine blood pressure and say, well, mine is usually higher, and therefore we have to get away from that narrative, and we have to understand that there are things we need to do to stay healthy. There are things we need to do to keep healthy. Some of the simple interventions that I highly recommend: go to your doctor regularly, get your annual wellness visits and annual physicals done. Get your preventative treatment done. Take your medicines. Keep yourself accountable. Black men suffer a lower life expectancy and a higher death rate than any other person in the United States. Even compared to black women. Even compared to black women. Even though we live in the same society, we live under the same circumstances, there is something wrong with that picture. This is the focus of this channel. I will continue to harp on some of these topics going forward. Please join me. Let's get healthier. Let's stay alive for our loved ones. This is Dr. Oriako with the Minority Health Report. Thank you for joining us. Please like, subscribe, share with your friends. Thank you.